Amazon File Cache is a new service that provides a high-speed cache on AWS, making it easier to process file data regardless of where the data is stored. Amazon File Cache serves as a temporary, high-performance storage location for data stored in on-premises file systems, AWS file systems, and Amazon S3 buckets, enabling customers to make dispersed datasets available to file-based applications on AWS with a unified view. Amazon File Cache delivers consistent sub-millisecond latency, up to hundreds of gigabytes per second of throughput, and up to millions of operations per second, helping you speed up workload completion times and optimize compute utilization. In this demo, we'll look at how to get started with Amazon File Cache. First, we head to the Amazon File Cache homepage, click Getting Started with Amazon File Cache, and then Create Cache. We'll call it Media Cache and give it a size of 9.6 tebibytes. File Cache also provisions an additional 2.4 tebibytes of metadata storage for each cache. The throughput is automatically calculated based on the configured storage capacity, which determines the maximum rate we can continuously write to or read from the cache. This throughput is shared between clients accessing the cache and data movement between the cache and data repositories. We'll provide network access to the cache by selecting Demo VPC as our VPC and an existing security group that allows traffic to flow through the required ports between File Cache and our compute instances that we'll be reading from it. We'll also use the default subnet. Encryption is automatically enabled, and we can encrypt the data using the default KMS encryption key, or we can opt to use a predefined key, such as a customer-managed key, by entering the ARN. Let's use the default key. After providing some tags on our new resource, we click Next. Up to 8 existing data repositories can be associated to a cache, and we can choose between NFS and S3 as the repository type. Let's create a cache that points to several NFS data repositories. First, we select NFS as the repository type and provide the data repository path. Since we're linking the cache to a single directory on this NFS file system, we'll also specify the directory along with a domain name and leave the subdirectories field empty. The DNS server IP addresses allow File Cache to resolve the domain name of the NFS server, which is useful when DNS resolution is private. Since we're associating NFS v3 servers deployed in an Amazon VPC and using the AWS-provided DNS server, we use the reserved DNS server IP address, which corresponds to the base of our VPC network CIDR range, plus 2, which in our case is 10.0.0.2. Next, we name the path Photos according to its content and click Add. Then, we repeat the same process for our second file server. When finished, we click Next to see a summary of our desired configuration. Finally, we click Create Cache and wait for the cache to be created. As we can see in the Details page, our new cache is now available, and the two data repositories have been successfully associated. We can get instructions on how to mount the new cache by clicking Attach and then copying the mounting command. Using an existing EC2 instance, which is configured with the adequate security group to allow traffic to our new cache, we execute that command in the terminal. Now that the cache has been mounted, we can access its content from the EC2 instance. In the first part of this demo, we saw how to create a cache that points to NFS data repositories. Let's now look at how to create a cache pointing to several S3 buckets containing photos and videos. First, we head back to the File Cache homepage and click on Create Cache. We'll use similar values as we did previously for the storage capacity, network, security, and encryption settings, and then click on Next. This time, we select Amazon S3 as the repository type, provide the S3 bucket name, and specify photos for the cache path. After clicking Add, we'll quickly create another data repository for the video files by providing the S3 bucket name, entering videos for the path, and then clicking Add. Now, we click Create Cache and wait for the cache to become available. Now that the second cache is available, we'll test it the same way we tested the previous one by copying the mount command and running it on our EC2 instance. And with that, we now have access to its content. To learn more about how to get started with Amazon File Cache, please visit the link shown below.